I'll answer some questions you may have about two of the best page builders of WordPress, Elementor and Divi. Which one is the best? Let's discover that in the next minutes. Well, because we talk about visual page builders here, and both have drag and drop functionality, they are user-friendly. You can see intuitive icons everywhere, which will help you find the custom capabilities of a section or element easily. In Elementor, the modules and settings are on the left, but in Divi, the module list reveals after you click on this plus icon here. Not a big difference, but when we want to change the settings of an element or section, the visual experience is way better than what you get in Elementor, because it opens in a pop-up window, which you can move around like this. Moreover, you can stick the window to the left side of your screen, like in Elementor. Furthermore, on both page builders, each icon will be revealed when you hover over it with your mouse cursor, and after you click on the icon, a list of available options will come up on your screen, like this. These are pretty much the same for both Elementor and Divi. One of the best things you can get in a visual page builder is the inline text editing available for both. What I discovered is that in Divi you have no way to insert a standalone heading element, so it might be hard for you to create a section title, for example. I really like it that in Elementor I can drag over a heading module, which I can use exactly as I want it. So, in terms of intuitive and user-friendly interface, both have high standards and are very easy to use. When you create a page on WordPress from scratch, with Elementor, you will drag over specific elements section by section until you finish it. You can use the default elements each and every page builder comes with, like the image, the text element, and more. In the Pro version of Elementor, for example, you will be able to drag over a premium pricing element too. The free version of Elementor gives you 45 items, which you can drag and drop to build custom pages and posts as well, where Divi comes with less. Starting with 2.0, Elementor gives you even more ready-made pieces of content you can play with, like blocks, which you can use to create custom pages section by section, like this. You can create headers and footers too, but these templates are available only for Pro users. Remember that you can extend the number of available elements with plugins for both page builders. Here is a video I recommend you to watch if you want to see 7 of the top-rated add-ons I'm talking about for Elementor. You can find a link to that video in the description box below, so check it out. For example, if you install and activate the OrbitFox WordPress plugin, you will be able to create a contact page like this, with just a couple of clicks. You can start with the default content, then everything you need to do is to customize it for your own needs. If you want to see more of what you can do with WordPress, please hit the like button below. Then, don't forget to subscribe and tap the bell to get notified every time we upload new videos. As I was saying, there are many unofficial plugins that have extra elements for each page builder, and you can find those WordPress plugins on the dashboard. The only limit here is your imagination. Both page builders in this video have a lot of custom capabilities available, and you can transform any element into something unique. For example, you can change the background of an element with solid colors, gradient, and images too. For some of the elements, you have the option to set a video background as well. In Divi, for example, you can set a parallax effect too. Furthermore, the text elements have almost everything you need to make them look great. If you want to deliver the best mobile experience ever, with Elementor you can slightly adjust the content to perfectly fit any screen size. You can do that in Divi too. For both page builders, you can set the visibility of an element or section. So, basically, you can choose to hide a specific element on a specific device. As you can observe by now, each page builder has a lot of options you can use to customize your content, and because of that, it's hard for me to pick a winner. My favorite one is Elementor, but you can decide for yourself until the end of this video, so keep watching. To cut things short and build basic websites fast, each page builder comes with hundreds of pre-made templates you can use to create content with a single push of a button. Do you remember the OrbitFox WordPress plugin mentioned earlier? That plugin has many unique ready-made templates you can use for free instantly after you click the import button. With the free version of Elementor, for example, you can create shape dividers above and below every section for a better visual experience, and the animated text element in the Pro version of this plugin will make your page more dynamic. Considering only these two things, your WordPress website will stand out for sure. The maintenance coming soon mode of Elementor is another unique function you can turn on right from its interface. One of Divi's unique feature is the parallax effect you can set to a background image, and there are more unique features you can play with. If you love free things like I do, I need to let you know that Elementor has a free version too, which you can install right from the WordPress repository on your dashboard. Divi have no free version available, but for only $89 per year, you will get access to all themes and plugins a premium member can get. If you want to spice things up a little bit with premium elements, Elementor Pro have a starting price of $49, which is a license you can use on one site, with updates and support for 1 year, starting the day of your purchase. I don't know exactly how many users has Divi from its almost 500k customers, but one thing is for sure, this page builder is so popular and WordPress fans are loving it. Elementor get the crown because of its 600k plus users. Nobody knows what figures we'll see in a year from now, or more, but one thing is for sure, they will grow. My favorite one is Elementor because of its many free features updated regularly. The number of ready-made page templates in the library and the possibility to import custom templates are also things that convinced me to use it every day. You are free to decide which one is better for your own needs. Then, please say it in the comment section below. And if you want to learn more about WordPress, check out these videos too. Remember to subscribe and tap the bell to know exactly when we publish new videos. You are all set. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.